Listen to the sound of footsteps in the dark, to voices that may not be quite human, to the sound of screams in the night, to the haunted cabaret, the home of all things horror, on RhodeIslandFreeRadio.org with your host, George Garner. The Haunted Cabaret starts now.
Scarlet Angel, the Czar, opening up this week's episode of The Haunted Cabaret here on Rhode Island Free Radio. I, as always, am your host, George Garner. Sitting across from me, also as always, is Chuckles the Evil Clown.
Ghoul evening. I just came back from a nasty stout of what you guys call diseases. I don't know how I caught it,
okay,
but I did.
A disease. Okay,
from
now,
one of you, a human disease. I'm not sure. This must be something that the Haunted Cabaret put in my microphone to get even with me for all those times that I've talked about.
Well, it might not have been a strictly human disease. I mean, it might have been one of those diseases that you can catch from frozen dead flesh, too. You know that.
I don't think so. I think it came from one.
Because you realize that you have. Because you realize that when you take one of those female cadavers that you love so much out of the refrigerator, you have to let them warm up to the point where they're adjustable.
I do. I put them in a giant size microwave.
Sure. And guess what happens when you thaw them out? That's when they can become disease ridden.
I got to start cleaning the microwave out a lot better.
You do. Well, what's on the way to rescue you? There are, I don't know. Now, I don't know how you think about what you think about this, but as a substitute, but they are working on very realistic, lifelike female, I would say love dolls, but it Have you heard about this? They look 100% lifelike. You can't tell them the difference from a living woman. And the only problem so far is that they are not animatronically animated, but they soon will be. Would you substitute, you know, it's kind of like a female Terminator with, you know, cleavage?
I don't know. Like, are you going to need the jaws of life if she gets lockjaw or something on you?
That, I think, is probably one of the things that they're testing and retesting and testing again. You know, I'm sure they're testing these devices, you know, more than they test the latest Toyota.
Of course you've watched this movie. You ever watched the movie Fido?
Fido.
One where the guy had the corpse tied up that he was making love to?
No, I've taken a hiatus from zombie films of all kinds.
It's a great idea, and trust me, it's a great movie. For those listening, it is a good movie. Until the mouth came around. I mean, it was great playing.
So the dog wasn't dead?
Oh, no, this wasn't a dog. This was a zombie the gentleman had tied up for his sexual pleasure. And instead of, it's great, you know, looking down, but eventually when those teeth came around, you know where they got them.
And they will come around.
Yeah, and it did. And I looked at that all the time and said, man, I kind of could use me something like that, a Return of the Living Dead. That'd be awesome, a zombie chick. And then I thought about it.
Well, you know, the same problem as now, refrigeration.
Right.
Because one of the weaknesses of all these zombie films from the days of Romero's original ones up until now, nobody wants to acknowledge the fact that this enduring zombie apocalypse will not actually happen that way. Because keep in mind, except for the fact that they're animated in the brain by the disease or whatever, you know, hook is in the particular story, these bodies are dead. Which means, I know all you zombie fans out there like to overlook this, that they are rotting at a very substantial, and it usually happens in the summer, so they're rotting away at a pretty fast pace. They're only going to be lethal creatures for the first few weeks until basically, you know, the crows, beetles, and cockroaches eat their legs out from under them and down they go.
That's a good point. However, I will argue.
So you will have to not. I'm just trying to look after your best interest here. So, you know, when it comes to zombie screwing, you're not going to be able to get away from refrigerating them, is my point.
Right. So I'll have to invest in a big refrigerator either.
Well, the same one you got now. You're just going to have to throw out the frozen females.
So Walt Disney's got to go out of there. I was keeping them there for storage. Now I'm going to have to throw them out. All right. I'll have to let them defrost.
Talk about breaking a big one on the Haunted Cabaret. Now, Walt Disney is in there. And now, by the way, this is an audio medium, so we can't see the look of chagrin on Chuckles' face right now. I can. You can't. Who else do you have in there besides Walt Disney?
There might be a couple dictators in there, one or two, that I might be using to paint as evil clowns to take over the world.
Okay.
Maybe.
Any musicians, any vocalists, any musicians in there?
Well, no.
The reason I asked this is because I had a very disturbing dream last night about Fat Elvis.
No, Elvis isn't in there. Elvis is buried in my backyard. He's not in the refrigerator.
Okay, because very peculiar. I had a dream last night. I visited Graceland, and Elvis was alive, but everybody else in it was dead. So, I don't know. I just wonder if that meant anything in light of this new revelation of yours.
No Elvis is in there. However, to step back a couple spots, remember how you said a lot of the movies aren't paying attention to the fact that zombies, they are dead and they are rotting?
Right.
I will have to give credit to this where credit is due. Walking Dead is following that.
Okay.
They are showing the decomposition and the rotting of the zombies.
So, but are they following a realistic timeline?
They are.
Okay.
The older they are, the longer they've been walking, the less of them there are. They even had a puddle or a goo one that was just
basically liquidation.
Yeah, and the teeth were there, but it was a zombie rotten. So they are following it pretty well in that one.
Excellent. Glad to hear somebody is. All right, let's go back to the music. Let's listen to a little. This is a little oddity for the Haunted Cabaret. I'm going to play a little Elvis Costello, but in our next talk segment, I will make abundantly clear why. This is Accidents Will Happen. On Rhode Island Free Radio's Haunted Cabaret.
Oh,
All right, that was Elvis Costello, Accidents Will Happen, off his Armed Forces album from way, way, way back when. It's one of those oldies, but it's an appropriate oldie based on the subject I have to discuss, which I actually wanted to start off the show discussing, but Chuckles led me astray with the necrophilia as usual.
Sorry.
No need to apologize. We have plenty of time left, and I'm always ready to talk about rotting corpses.
That's why it's the Haunted Cabaret.
Exactly. But what I want to discuss now is something a little more serious and a little more, you know, significant, I guess you could say. All this fuss about, you know, this, you know, Malaysian Flight 17 and all this tension between Russia and the United States. I mean, Russia being blamed for shooting this plane down. I don't know. I know a lot of people that are older than us have a nostalgia for the Cold War. I mean, I think that's part of it. I mean, it's just not the same world if you're not threatening to nuke each other if you're Russia and the United States. I mean, military men miss it. You know, the conservative fanatics miss it. The liberals miss being able to deplore the whole ignorant thing. You know, everybody misses the Cold War, so I can understand trying to get it going again. But this is not the incident to get it going, because this actually was not directly, the Russians' fault. Because I have it on good authority. Now, I have a contact. I'm not going to go into much detail here. But I have a contact. He's basically, I would say refugee, but he's from the, put it this way, he's Russian. And I ran into him on my third shift job, which I used to pay the bills because, you know, until we can ramp up the Haunted Cabaret into a money-making venture, you know, I do have a regular square job paying the bills. And anyway, I was, and I won't say where because of the circumstances, you'll realize in a second, but I was talking to this Russian. It was after midnight. I guess he had had a few in him. And he said that, you know, he had learned a few things based on his family still in Russia. And they live close to this Ukraine situation, you know, with this Crimea, where, you know, all this trouble is taking place between the Russians and the Ukrainians. And it directly affects this missile that shot down Malaysian Flight 17. I mean, we all know this. You know, the general story, right? The plane blew up, you know, like 250-some people are on it. A bunch of famous scientists were on it. You know, to hear them talk, you would think the whole world was on it, the fuss they're making about this one friggin' plane being shot down. But anyway, but the point is that the Russians are getting a bad rap on this. I mean, this man told me this, and although he was in a drunken stupor, I believe him. Because, yes, a missile did hit that plane, and it did blow up the plane, and the plane splattered all over Ukraine. That's fact. What's not so well known is that they weren't aiming for the plane. The Russians just misfired this terrorist missile or whatever it was. You know, as the Russians often, you know, most of their military hardware is worth crap, so it doesn't pretty much aim where you shoot it. They were trying to shoot down the monster, flying monster Mothra.
I knew something like this was coming around. I just had this feeling. I'm just sitting there, my dead hamsters are running around in the wheels saying, where the hell is this man going with this one? I knew it, Mothra.
No, you didn't know it because I might have been going toward Rodan.
Oh, okay.
It might have been Rodan. The reason that it's unimpeachably Mothra. Now, here's the other thing this drunk Russian told me, okay? Now, Chuckles, I know that you're tired. I know you put in a day of terrorizing people and necrophilia. But try to put a couple of important facts together here, okay? One, missile shoots down plane trying to shoot down flying monster, okay? That's one fact. The other fact is that on this plane, there was a zillion research scientists, okay, involved in biological research, okay? Now, this plane, and it was in Ukrainian/Russian territory. I mean, we all know that Ukraine equals Russia nowadays. You know what I'm saying? Those Ukrainians are deluded if they think anything else is going to happen. Okay? Now, the falsification, the big, never mind Mothra, set that aside, okay? That's only a small incident in this whole big picture. The big falsification is that these scientists were AIDS researchers. Actually, according to this drunk Russian, I think he was on a little weed too, but mostly drunk. But anyway, but it didn't cloud the fact of his good, you know, he was logical and he put this case together very accurately. These research scientists were not investigating AIDS research. They were developing radiation-altered bioweapons to be used in the Russian war against Ukraine.
Ah, okay.
Okay?
Yep.
Now, and this is why I have deduced, and I'm breaking it on the Haunted Cabaret, that it wasn't Rodan, the monster Rodan, that that tried to destroy that plane. Okay? Because Rodan is, you know, Rodan, anything that's flying, Rodan knocks it down. Okay? Rodan's hostile. Mothra, on the other hand, chooses its targets more carefully. It is Mothra is usually a very beneficent creature, looking out for humanity's and the world's best interests. Okay? Now, put all these pieces of the puzzle together. Mothra attacked that plane because it housed an entire coach class of the most devious, demented, bio-warfare specialist scientists ever gathered in one place, heading toward a summit on former Soviet territory in order to distill, in order, to, I can't even hardly think straight on the horror of this, in order to distill an radiation-altered organism, last presented to us in the Toho film of the ninth, the Gora the Space Monster. Now, I don't know if many of my listeners remember this. It was very obscure, and it's very obscure for a reason, because it came too close to the truth. Yes, radiation-altered cells will grow into giant tentacled floating creatures, which can be sent on missions of destruction once programmed to attack the appropriate country. And that's what these scientists were bringing back to Mother Russia for a hefty, let's just say a hefty fee, a hefty reward. And that's why Mothra attacked this plane, trying to destroy this bioorganism before it could get into the hands of those damn commies who never stopped being commies. I don't care what, I don't care that the president now, he's the czar, which is why we dedicated, by the way, the first, you know, that's the czar. We started off our show. Accidents. See, this is a theme. This is a carefully orchestrated theme. I'm attempting. I'm attempting to be mature and handle a modern social political issue in a mature, thoughtful way.
I think you were handling that joint in a mature and thoughtful way with this Russian.
You know what? I thought better of you.
Never think better of an evil clown.
A skeptic. Again and again, you know, I have tried to tell people the truth about some of this nonsense going on, some of this false propaganda filling our airways, and this is the thanks I get in my own studio.
I'm going to give you a thanks. I think I'm going to ask the nurse to bring one of her straitjackets so you can come home with me, so when we leave this spot, you can discuss this theory with Dr. DeGrade back at the Gardner Hill Insane
Asylum. Listen, I need to discuss it with somebody because I tried to get through to President Obama. They're not taking my calls.
Right. He doesn't take my calls either, but that's a totally different situation because I beheaded the man on television.
Okay, I was just going to say, I have to ask, I have to interrupt this important subject just to ask, what exactly are you trying to contact the President of the United States about?
To say I'm sorry.
I think you just said it.
I was going to say
here
I'm
on,
sorry.
Here on the Haunted Cabaret, from us, from Chuckles the Evil Clown to President Barack Obama, who has given me my Obamacare health insurance. So, Chuckles, I'm glad to hear you say that. He has said he's sorry after all this time.
Of course I'm going to say I'm sorry. This is the third Antichrist coming up here. I want to be on his side.
Okay, let's put it this way. You are feeling the taste of fear from this Antichrist. Let's get back to the music, song of that name, Shadows Fall, here on the Haunted Cabaret. As usual, we have arrived before I was ready at the end of our show, but I hope I've given you some food for thought this week.
Yep, definitely.
Good.
Definitely, and I'll give you some pills for thought, too, when we get out of here.
Okay, and in spite of your sarcasm, I am still going to participate on the... What was that? What was the name of that show that I agreed against my will to participate in to help you out?
Have a good time. I think it's called Chuckles Crypt.
Okay, Chuckles Crypt
only,
it is.
Only here on Rhode Island Free Radio.
Hey, listen, now that is a tag team to equal the Wild Samoans. Chuckles is Crypt and the Haunted Cabaret.
That's right, and this radio station does not charge us to go to the bathroom, which is one of the reasons this will only be here.
Yes, and if that is a cryptic comment to most of you out there, it is not to us. When you meet us in person sometime, ask us about it, and we will have a story to tell you. For the moment, we are out of here, though. Let's get out of here with a little Motorhead. That's always a good band to leave on. How about Love Me Like a Reptile here on the Haunted Cabaret, Rhode Island Free Radio. Nighty night.